See what I just did?
No, but I felt it.
Well, that's the way I want you to start every fight. In a saloon or in the ring. No coming out messing around with a bunch of fancy footwork. Now look, it's a three-step move, like you're setting him up for a right-hand lead. You see? My right hand looks like I'm getting ready to throw it. This will cause the guy to raise his left hand to block it. As he does, move to the left very quickly, like this. Bang! Liver shot. This will bring down the right hand. Then you hook over the right hand with your left. Pow! Right to the chops. If that doesn't put him down, you throw a straight right hand, bang! And if that doesn't put him down, run for your life, because he's gonna tear your head off. Okay.
Do it again.
All right. One, two, three.
Okay. One more time. One more time.
Bang! 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 Okay? Try it. That's it. That's the ticket. That's it. Now practice those moves so you can do them in your sleep.
Okay.
Okay, now keep your hands up. Okay? Now let's have some fun. Watch yourself, Harry, because this is for real. Not bad. You learn very fast. Now how about this one?
Jeez, Bruno, I didn't mean to hit you so hard.
The heck you didn't. That's a pretty fair left hook you've got there.
Fair? Knock you down, isn't it?
Didn't knock me out, though. I'll tell you what, another year or so, it would have killed me.
And I'm over yet.
It is for me.
Come on.
No, no, I'm not as young as I was. Let's take a look at that face. Gotta get that skin tough as leather. Yeah. Can't have the fight stopped just because of some lousy cut. Well, the beef brine seems to be doing the job.
I put on every day, just like you told me.
Okay, put some on now.
I already did it today, Bernie.
Put some on now.
Put it on already.
Now! You know me.
Sure gonna miss you, Bernie. Ain't the same here without you.
Well, thanks, Rick. No, no, that's not the way you're supposed to. You're supposed to put on lots of it. Here. Harry, you can trust me. I'm your brother.
You boys through playing? There's work to be done.
Sure, Pa.
When I become champion of the world, you're gonna be right there with me, Bernie.
Brother, you got yourself a deal.
You children go and get ready for bed now. Ellie and Florence, let's go. What's troubling you, sir?
He's been gone 6 months already.
It's more than just you missing your brother, isn't it?
I guess I'm a little scared about going away tomorrow.
Nothing for you to be scared of. You just do the Lord's will and he'll take care of you just fine.
That ain't it, Ma. Something else. It's always been with me.
You're special. That's what you're feeling. Something big's waiting for you. And you're right. Because you ain't your pa. Your pa's a dreamer. And you ain't your brother Bernie either. You're different. You gotta remember that always.
Yes, ma'am.
Since you was 10 years old, you've been training hard to be a fighter. Bernie's taught you good. You got the makings, Harry. Something here. I've been saving this for you. I got it from an old peddler. He's got John L. Sullivan himself. He was quite a man. I read this book while I was waiting for you to be born. And I knew then that you was going to be a fighter just like Mr. Sullivan. That you'd be champion of the world someday. Do you understand what I'm telling you, son?
I won't let you down, Ma.
I know you won't. Now, you go out and say goodbye to your pa. Go on.
Oh, I'm leaving tomorrow. Oh, I said I'm...
I heard you. You're leaving tomorrow. Your mother told me.
Just wanted to say goodbye.
Well, you said it. Notice of luck, good or bad. Each man chooses his own life. So how hard world out there, Harry.
Can't be much worse than it's been here.
See for yourself.
I aim to.
That free lunch is going to cost you a nickel beer. Thank you.
That free lunch can be worth more to you than a nickel. Now, I'm a first-class fighter. Now, you can pass the hat, and we'll split it right down the middle.
We get enough fights in here without promoting any.
Well, I'll lay odds you got one guy in here that nobody wants to fight. I know you got one. Loud, always bothering paying customers.
Yeah, we got one of them. Freddie Lujak.
Freddie Lujak, huh?
Yeah.
Well, how's about I take care of him for you?
Be here tonight. You better eat.
About 100 fights this year alone, in and out of saloons.
How many did you win?
No stroke.
That's some car, huh?
Yep.
Listen, I wonder if you'd do me a small favor.
Social Club presents Jack Dempsey versus George Coker. 10 rounds of boxing, 8 o'clock p.m., September 1, 1914. How come you always use Jack Dempsey's name, Bernie?
I used to idolize Jack Dempsey when I was a kid, about your age. He's a tough old Irish fighter. Well, how about it? You fight Copeland for me?
What's the matter, Bernie? You sick or something?
Truth. I'm 40, Harry. I got nothing left. Besides that, the air is too thin up here. I have trouble breathing just walking down the street. You've got young lungs. You can handle it. And Copeland, he's nothing. We'll dump him easy.
Last time somebody told me that, I nearly got myself killed.
Yeah, but I'm your brother, Harry. You can trust me.
Okay, what's your name, kid?
Jack Dempsey.
Jack Dempsey, come on, Bernie, that's you.
Not anymore.
Okay, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, in this corner, weighing 234 and one quarter, George Copeland. And in this corner, weighing Jack Dempsey,
I can't breathe.
Harry, you got it.
If he gets up one more time, so help me, Bernie. I'm going down myself. I mean it.
Price, I didn't believe the kid when he told me he could hit like a heavyweight. I was only doing his brother Bernie my old pile of favor by putting you two together. Well, I'm a newspaper man. I'm no fight manager. Thought the kid was going to get himself killed. What I know, huh? He says to me, Mr. Flotto, I'd rather die in the ring than starve to death in some alley. How do you like them apples?
I like it.
Put away a good boy tonight, Jack.
Yeah. Joe Bonds? He used to be in Jack Kern's stable. You can bet he'll hear about tonight. He keeps tabs on all his fighters, even the ones he lets go.
$400. That's my biggest purse yet. I want to thank you, Mr. Price, for getting me this fight. I appreciate it.
Chicken feed. The real dough's in New York.
Well, that's where I'm going. New York.
How's about I go with you? Be your manager.
It's okay by me, it's okay by Otto.
Hey, I've been to New York and you can have it. All right, you guys go. I gotta get back to my desk. I can't go gallivanting around the country with a couple of mugs like you two. It's bad for my image.
Shake.
Whoa. I hope this ain't what I know it is.
All right. That's all. Out. Slow. It ain't funny and I'll blow your head off.
You too, champ. Guy in the back, out. Out!
What's in here?
My pajamas.
It's pure silk. You got style, Fat Man. You really got style.
Take it easy, champ. It's only money.
You boys come visit again, you hear?
Well, they could have taken the car, too.
You're a million laughs, Otto.
We were sailing along on Moonlight Bay. We could hear the voices ringing. They seemed to say, you have stolen my heart.
Let's drink to a night's work.
Luckily, I always keep a C-note stashed. We can eat. Blow this dump.
She plays a good piano.
You think so?
I know so. I'm a song and dance man myself. Managing fighters is just a sideline.
This is some menu. It's ridiculous. I have seen better prices in a dozen first-class saloons.
Order me some.
Remember me?
Shall we help out?
Jack's doing just fine. Look at the fish.
My hero. All that money belonged to you?
Most of it.
How did I help you spend your share? Come on. What's a little money among friends?
All right.
Cut me down. You're strong. What'll you have?
I'll have a beer.
A beer for my friend, the usual for me. I haven't seen you in here before.
I've been in here before.
I'm Maxine. Maxine Cates.
Jack Dempsey. I'm a prize fighter.
Prize fighter. I've always had a soft spot for prize fighters. You gonna be around for a while?
I wish I was. I'm on my way to New York City.
Here's to you, champ.
What's with the kid? That skirt's old enough to be his mother.
Maybe he's homesick.
You were really something with those two men. One of them had a gun, did you know that?
It didn't make no difference. I've been beat out of my money so many times before, I wasn't about to let it happen again.
What's it feel like not to be afraid?
I don't know. I've always been afraid.
What?
Being poor.
There's more than one way to be poor. New York's a very lonely town.
Oh, I won't be lonely there. I got you to think about now.
I could go with you, Jack. Nothing holding me here.
Well, I'd like nothing more, Maxine. That's the honest truth.
But you can't take me, right? Money again. Why is it that money's always between me and what I want?
What do you want?
I don't know. Could be you. There I go, whistling Dixie again. You and me in some combination. 20-year-old kid, never mind. I'd be robbing the cradle, that's for sure.
Don't say that, Maxine. Don't never say that. I ain't never been a kid. I ain't never had the time.
Me neither. Will you come back for me, Jack?
Oh, I'll come back for you. You can bet your life on it.
Maybe I will.
We ain't so much a smell fight.
We'll get one. We just gotta stick it out.
I'm through, Jack. This is as far as I go. Where's my family? My mom's sick, real bad. I gotta see her.
What about your singing and your dancing?
I'm not gonna ever stage door on Broadway. It just ain't in the cards for me. New York. I don't want us here, Jack. It's time to go home.
I gotta stay.
What's that?
$50. I'm your new manager. Price sold me a contract.
I never had a contract with Price. Who are you?
John Riesler. Friends call me John the Barber.
Oh, yeah, I know who you are.
Whatever you had with Price, you got with me. I can get you Sam Langford.
I'm not ready for Langford.
Gunboat Smith.
I'm not ready for Smith either.
Well, I got a kid sister. Maybe go 10 rounds with her. Listen, you want to be a fighter? Or just talk about it. I'll wait for you outside. You should have flattened that coon in six. You're in, kid. 100 Iron Men.
Plus.
Plus what?
Plus 25% of your cut of the gate. That's what you said.
I said, forget what I said. You get what I lay on the table. What's wrong?
I think I busted some ribs.
Hey!
Take it easy.
It's sore. It ain't busted. Lay up a couple of days.
It's gonna take more than a couple of days.
Kid, you know what I think? I think Price sold me a quitter. That's what I think.
Don't ever say I quit. You understand?
Yeah. Sure, kid, sure. So you got a couple of busted ribs. Rest up. Take your time. Yeah, I'll line us up with another good fight.
I'm all through fighting for you.
What?
You heard me. Find yourself another piece of meat. We're through.
Well, you think so? You think so? Well, you listen to me, kid, and you listen good. You don't fight for me, you don't fight for nobody. Not in New York, not any place. You got that straight? I'll blackball your ugly kisser from here to Timbuktu. You'll be on the end of the bread line in a month.
I've been there before. Won't kill me.
Sorry things didn't work out for you.
Well, I will. Next time. What I have to do is I have to establish what they call a reputation. I have to get a string of knockouts against some good boys, some class fighters. Like they got here in Salt Lake. Kansas City, too.
Is that what you came back for? A reputation?
You still got a soft spot for fighters?
Try me.
Marry me, Maxine. One of these days, I'm going to put the whole world in the palm of your hand.
What if I can't hold on to it?
I'll help you.
Nothing in there going to get us rich. A ranch hand, a miner. Not exactly jobs with a future.
I'm doing my best.
Yeah, I know. Is this all there is?
I'll get more. Bernie's got a good fight for me over in Murray. Why don't you come? It's been 6 months now, you ain't never seen me fight. You'd like Bernie.
No, thanks. Hanging around some jerkwater town where you beat somebody's brains out ain't exactly my idea of a swell time.
Yeah, well, that's all it is with you, isn't it? Swell times and dough.
Yeah, I get so much of it with you every night. Jack Dempsey, the last of the high rollers.
I'll make money. I'll make it.
I've heard that song too many times before, Jack. It's all played out. I ain't blaming you. It's just the way it is. You'll never be champion of anything, ever. Face it before you start hearing bells in your head. The last thing I need is a punch-drunk fighter to take care of.
Would you ever have to take care of me?
Go to hell, Dempsey.
You are not going out tonight. Not tonight.
Did you hear him out there, Bernie? Did you hear him out there? Everybody out there thinks I went into the tank.
That guy would have killed you.
I don't care.
I care.
One more round, Bernie. Just one more round. One more round and I could have had him. Now everybody out there thinks I threw that fight.
They don't mean nothing. They want blood, let them go to the Red Cross. Now jump up here, Harry, please. Let me fix that eye.
Just one more round, Bernie.
It's after three. Where you been?
What difference does it make? I'm here now.
I can smell the whiskey from here.
You owe 2 weeks' rent.
Aren't you gonna ask if I won or lost?
Did you win or lost?
Money's in the top drawer. Why don't you lay off the booze?
Why should I?
Why don't you get out of that cheap dress and get some sleep?
What's the matter with this dress? I bought it with my own money. Maybe you want me to dress like your mother, is that it?
What's your mouth, Max?
Well, even two. Hit me? Come on, Price, fight. I've been hit before.
Not by me.
Oh, not yet. Not yet. But come, I ain't never met your precious mother.
But you never wanted to.
You've never said nothing about it.
Neither did you.
Not to me. You're a little baby boy. No woman's good enough for a little Harry. That's what it's all about. Damn you. Damn you. You're asleep on me. Sleep like a laugh. Whoever sleeps with their eyes open. You. You know how spooky it is to see you lie there with your eyes open. I don't know if you're asleep or dead. I'm talking to you. You shame me. I ain't good enough to meet your mother. Your mother's safe. Listen to me, Pastor. That's what it's all about, isn't it? You're ashamed of me.
Yeah, I'm ashamed. I'm ashamed I ever married you.
Yeah. I don't have the rent yet, Mr. Delaney. My wife took all the money.
Well, she left a week ago.
Well, you're gonna get it.
This just came for you.
Thank you.
Dempsey? You Kearns? You look terrible, kid. You're a hard man to find. I've been tracking you ever since you beat Joe Bonds.
I move around a lot.
Well, the only way you're gonna move from now on is up. Let's go.
I want to thank you for giving me this opportunity, Mr.
Save the thanks, kid. Just win every time I put you to the ring. We start with Willie Meehan, and you got 3 weeks to get ready.
I'll be ready.
You're darn right you will. Come here.
How are we doing? Let us get 4 fights, 3 wins and a draw. 2 KOs. 4 KOs would have been cleaner. Let's stop before I have a heart attack. This is a life, huh, Kez?
Yeah, I know.
This ain't nothing. Only one way to live, the way the champ lived. You don't talk much, do you, kid?
Not much to say.
Let's take with me. You do the fighting, I'll do the talking. But if you ever feel like letting off a little steam, I'll listen. I'm a real good listener. I was a fighter once. Thought I'd get me all the dames and dough I'd ever want. Don't know a fighter who doesn't want both. Is that what you want, kid? Dames and dough?
Nothing wrong with having them.
Depends on which comes first. Take it from me, kid. Keep the dames in the closet. I never could. Why do you do it, kid? I know it's different with every fighter. What's it with you? It's got to be more than the dames and the dough.
Fighting's all I got. It's the only way I know to move up.
Yeah?
When I'm fighting, everybody's looking at me. When I'm not fighting, I'm just... another guy trying to hang on.
What else? Come on, Jack, you can tell me.
I don't never want to go hungry again.
Nobody does. What else?
I want everybody to know who I am. Everybody knows the heavyweight champion of the world. You don't have to wait in line for nothing. You're the champ.
I can get you Gunboat Smith.
Get him. Losing a fight and all. I mean, I guess Smith was just a little bit too much for me.
Kit. Who am I?
Doc Kern, what?
Where are we?
We're in Mission Park, San Francisco. Doc, I'm okay. I just didn't want to let you down.
Jack? You won. You won, do you hear me? Smith nearly put you away in the second, but you got up. I don't know how you did it, but you got up. Beat the living daylights out of him. Ain't nobody who can stop us now. Nobody.
I won. I beat him.
Yeah.
I beat Gunboat Smith. Did I hurt him?
Mr. Dempsey, Mr. Dempsey, I've been waiting. Can I have your autograph?
Sure, kid.
Thanks, champ.
First autograph. It won't be your last.
This is just the beginning, Mom.
Well, you're spoiling me, son. It's a beautiful house. Still, $5,000 is a lot of money.
Well, I'm doing pretty good now, Ma. One day I'm gonna buy you a palace.
Oh, this is gonna do me just fine, son.
I don't know. I'd kind of like to live in a palace.
My baby brother, the next heavyweight champion of the world.
Do you think that Mr. Willard will fight you, son?
Well, he told Doc he would when the war was over, and war's over.
Supposing you fight him, and he beats you, huh?
He ain't gonna beat me, Pa.
Come on, Harold. Let's go.
Don't pay Pa no mind, Harry. You know him. Voice of Doom.
I'm gonna win that title. I'm gonna wrap it around his neck.
Wouldn't that be a sight?
Always chasing rainbows, waiting to find a bluebird in
Bill.
buy you a drink?
I buy my own drinks.
Oh, come on. What's one drink between friends?
You're no friend of mine.
I could be. I could be a real close friend.
Get lost. Hey, can't you take a joke?
Sure. Sure, I can take a joke.
Well, I can't. Take a walk.
Sorry, pal. This is my husband. Say hello to the one and only Jack Dempsey.
Jack Dempsey, the fighter? Yeah, I didn't mean anything, Mr. Dempsey. I don't want no trouble, really. Thank you.
You look like a pimp.
You don't look so hot yourself.
How'd you find me?
Bernie. He heard from a guy who heard from a guy who heard...
What do you want? Come to tell me I told you so? You're a big shot now, number one contender for the title and all that junk.
I'm going to New York. I'm going to file for divorce.
Congratulations.
Is that all you got to say?
What else should I say? Take me with you? I asked you once before. Beg you, maybe. Forget it. You got your life. Leave me to mine.
Some life you got.
Don't knock it, Jack. You can't be a fighter forever. Burn out just like the rest of them. Come see me when you're all grown up. I'll buy you a drink. You'll probably need it.
Until I do, have a nightcap on me. I gotta know something. Why'd you marry me?
Because you asked me.
Dempsey was here in New York a year ago when I saw him fight. He had a punk manager then, John the Barber. A real rongo. Dempsey's a good kid.
Dempsey's no problem. But I know Kearns from the Klondike days. He weighted gold for me at the Great Northern. He used the hair grease scam when he worked the scales.
That's a new one on me.
You see, gold dust sticks to the fingers. Kearns would smooth back that pompadour of his, and the gold would end up on the grease in his hair. Later on, he'd wash it out. He must have picked up a tiny sum that way.
Sounds like Kearns. Speaking of grease...
He's here. Remember, let me do the talking.
You're the doctor. Gentlemen, I'm Damon Runyon. I believe you two are old friends.
Kenneth Runyon.
Tex, this is Jack Dempsey. Jack, Tex Ricker.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Ricker.
Jack, sit down. Join us.
Straight bourbon. Nothing for my son. And put it on his tab.
Same old Kurt.
Next round's on me.
Oh, that'll be a switch.
Gentlemen, I didn't set up this meeting to be a referee. I'm a newspaper man. So, let's cut the this and that and one thing and another and give me some news.
Here's news for you. Tex Rickard guarantees Willard $100,000 to fight Dempsey for the title. How's that for a leader?
I see you've changed your brand to hair grease.
Clean as a whistle.
Your boy's too small. He's no match for Jess. You want a killing on your hands? The public wouldn't pay a wooden nickel to see that lineup.
The killing? Where you been for 2,000 years? The public goes to the fights for one thing, to see somebody get hurt. to see blood. They love it. They don't want to see the art of boxing. Killing! Listen, if anybody's going to get killed, it's going to be Jess Willard. Because my boy here is going to knock that big bum into next week. So, Rickard, what do you want? A fight? Or two guys waltzing around the park?
Can't figure Willard. I closed him for 40,000 against Moran. At the last minute, he held me up for 60 grand.
He'll sign for 100 and kiss your ring in the middle of Times Square. It'll be the biggest guarantee ever. How can you turn it down?
It would take a record gate just to break even.
Don't worry about the gate. The whole country's waiting for this fight. You're gonna make a bundle.
Don't con me, Kearns.
What con? Look, we're both playing with the same deck, and you're dealing. Send Willard a telegram. What's it gonna cost you? A lousy sawbuck?
Could cost me 100,000 plus.
You was always a gambling man, Rickard. Since when you've been living scared? I'm telling you, True Blue, this will be the fight of the century. You're the only promoter that can make it happen.
All right. Let's say I get Willard. What's your end for Dempsey?
Make it easy for yourself, like 50 grand.
25.
Talk about con. 40. That's my bottom dollar.
You dig deeper.
Okay. With a gun at my head. 30 grand, but that's as low as I go.
What do you think?
Well, all the sports writers in town, including myself, figured this fight would get settled on nickels and dimes. Why don't you split the difference? 27.5.
Kearns?
Done.
Done.
Days and not a word from Rickard, Doc. What if Willard turns him down?
Listen, for 100 grand, Willard would fight his mother in the closet. He may be old, but he ain't crazy.
Well, maybe we are.
Relax, kid. I just got us a couple of great-looking bimbos dying to put smiles on our faces.
Did you leave where we're gonna be?
All over town. A blind man could find us.
Going our way, boys?
Do cats eat canaries?
Listen, go call Rickard, will you, Doc? I can't stay there no more. I gotta know now.
Don't move, kid.
That music's something. So what do you do, Mr. Dempsey?
I'm in real estate.
Charming, I'm sure.
Thank you.
no go, huh?
We're in, kid. We're in. Ladies, it's champagne time.
One of those nice, isn't it?
Now they're betting.
Still 4-1 against you. It must be 100 degrees out here.
106.
Go.
The big bum out in the first round. That gives me $100,000. You can do it.
I want a good, clean fight. No rabbit punch, no kidney punch, no low blow. When I say break, I mean break. Shake hands. Come on at the bell.
There for you, kid. All you have to do is take it.
You lost your bet, Doc.
Forget the bet. Get out there and bury the bucket.
Wait, Jess, you've had enough.
Away, Jack. Put him away.
I'm trying, Doc. I'm trying.
Come on.
machine.
That ought to be good for a few sleepless nights.
Why the long face, kid?
It's only a flat tire, not the end of the world.
Down the road, Doc. I can't take this traveling circus thing anymore. I mean, it's embarrassing. I'm heavyweight champion of the world, and I'm punching out stiffs 8 shows a week.
$7,500 a week, that's not easy to walk away from.
Well, it is for me. I've had it. Come on, get me another fight, Doc, or let's go to New York. Anything's better than this.
We can do anything we want. How about California?
What's in California?
What's in California? Haven't you heard of Hollywood, the movies?
Movies? Doc, I can't act.
You don't have to act. You'll be the hero. They got everything out there. Palm trees, coconuts, best-looking dames in the world. What are we waiting for?
For you to change this tire.
I'll ruin my suit.
Good. About time. Come on. Give me a hand.
Now,
Jack.
We're trying to make a movie here, Kearns.
What do you know what you can do with a movie?
You got a big mouth.
Come on, what is it with you two? Amateur night at the garden? Now, take it easy, both of you. Maybe I'll be right back.
All right.
Now, what's so important, Doc?
How about your whole life? It's Maxine. She's making big trouble for us, big.
Not support. We were sending her money all along.
We're going to tell that to the jury.
Mr. Dempsey, the United States federal government charges you with unlawfully, knowingly, willfully, and feloniously evading and attempting to evade the draft on the grounds of dependency. Is there any truth in these allegations?
No, sir. I never ran away from the war. I never lied or cheated to get out of serving my country.
Did your local draft board defer you from military duty as the sole support of your family?
I never heard from my local draft board.
Why was that?
Well, I don't know, sir. I guess since they all knew me and my family, they knew I was the only one who could take care of them.
And Miss Cates, she accuses you of non-support.
I don't know why she said all those lies about me in the newspapers. I always supported Maxine, Miss Cates, even when we weren't living together as husband and wife.
Mr. Dempsey, what did you do for the war effort?
Well, I fought exhibition bouts for the Naval Relief Fund. I helped raise money for the Red Cross. I went to shipyards and defense plants on Liberty Bond rallies. I did whatever was asked of me.
Who asked you to help out?
The United States federal government.
Mr. Dempsey, at this time, were you the heavyweight champion of the world?
No, sir. I didn't become champion until after the war.
Thank you, Mr. Dempsey. No further questions.
Dempsey, it's up to you. She's the only witness against you.
I feel sorry for her.
Sorry for her? For what? Maxine missed the boat with you. All she's after is your money. And she doesn't care how she gets it.
Mr. Dempsey, if you're telling me to go easy on Maxine Cates, then everything we've gained so far will be worthless.
Proof of your financial support's one thing, but I want to make sure that the jury, that nobody believes a single word of Maxine Case's testimony. Not a word. And if they don't believe her, they won't believe the federal government. Well, I only know one way to do that. It won't be pretty. Neither is having the name Slacker hang around your neck for the rest of your life.
All right, Mr. McNabb. Go ahead and do what you have to do.
Miss Cates, you've said that as a cabaret singer, you earned $35 a week. Not much for you to live on, was it?
I don't understand your question.
Miss Cates, did you ever earn money as a prostitute?
No.
How much money did Mr. Dempsey send you in 1917?
I don't remember. Maybe $500.
I have here some canceled checks. All made out to you, signed by Mr. Dempsey, all dated during the year 1917. The total sum of $2,000. Now, I can supply more of the same kind of evidence, Western Union receipts as well, all showing that Mr. Dempsey more than fulfilled his financial obligation to you in the year 1917.
So he sent me some money. Big deal. I was his wife, wasn't I?
Was all this money enough for you to live on? Together, of course, with your earnings as a cabaret singer.
I suppose so. Barely.
Miss Cates, did you ever earn money as a prostitute?
Your Honor, I object. She's already answered the question.
Then I suggest that she change her answer. Unless Counselor Thomas wants me to subject this court to a parade of his client's satisfied customers. Men such as Charles Williams, Edgar Matthews, Peter Racine, and so on, so on, so on.
Order. Order in the courtroom. Objection sustained. The witness has already answered the question.
I put it to you that you accepted money from men for their sexual favors.
Your Honor, I object. How Miss Cates earned her living is not the issue here.
Objection sustained.
If it is not, this is the first time since Moses brought down the laws from Mount Sinai that prostitution is being argued in a court of law as a legitimate means of livelihood. Is that what you want this court to believe, Miss Cates?
Look, nobody took care of me my whole life. I do whatever I have to do to stay alive. If a man wants something from me, he's got to pay for it. I don't give nothing away. That's being a prostitute, then I say, so what? It's only a name. There are a lot worse names.
Like extortionist? I put it to you, Miss Cates, that your charges of non-support against my client are nothing more than attempts at extortion.
Jack Dempsey was a deadbeat when he was with me. I'm the one that kept us alive. You ask him who put the bread on the table. It was me, that's who. And he never asked where the money came from. Now, I'm asking. I want what's mine. If that's extortion, you could all go to hell.
Thank you, Mr.
Kirk. The jurors will ignore the witness's last statements.
No further questions.
Miss Cates. Miss Cates, you may step down.
Forward.
happened to you?
What's so exciting about it?
Right.
That crowd last night? I'll never be a real champion to them. Winning that slacker trial didn't mean a thing.
Forget the crowd, Jack. People only want heroes so they can tear them down. It's been that way ever since David beat Goliath. 46, 47, 48, 49, 50. 50,000 for me. And 550,000 for the winner, and still heavyweight champion of the world. How do you feel?
Okay.
You were smart to pick up your money before Kearns got a hold of it. But he's not going to like it.
No, I don't suppose he will.
Jack, I'm going to talk to you as your friend. Let me invest your money for you.
Well, I don't think that's necessary now, Tex, now that I'm picking it up on myself every time.
Money makes money, Jack. But you got to keep it moving. What's Kearns done for you so far, A few buildings in Florida, a second-rate hotel in Hollywood. Your money is just sitting there, Jack, doing nothing. It's not even collecting interest in that Oklahoma oil deal. Now, what in heaven's name was that? You guys took a bath on that one. That was a real sucker's bet. Jack. I can set you up so you don't have to worry about money for the rest of your life. Isn't that what you want, Jack? Isn't that what you've always wanted?
You did what? I put it in a trust fund.
A trust fund? How much?
All of it. You're a damn fool. I could have doubled that money in no time. Haven't I always taken care of things? Haven't I always looked out for you?
No, Doc, you haven't. Not with my money. Every time you made a pickup, I came up short. Until this fight.
We've got expenses. A payroll to meet. Tate pays the rest of the guys. They don't work for nothing.
That's not what I'm talking about.
Okay. So I'm short sometimes. I borrow from you. So what? I'll pay it back, every cent.
That's not what I'm talking about either.
Then what are you talking about?
I'm talking about the fact that I'm not gonna wind up in the gutter. Not for you and not for anybody.
All right, Jack. Have it your way. But don't come crying to me when some Sharpie pulls the rug out from under you.
I won't.
Good. I'm telling you, Jack, this girl is a real stunner. A classy lass.
This girl wants to meet me.
So help her.
You've been pulling my leg, would you, Woody?
Would I do that to a friend?
Yeah.
You're right.
I know.
But in this case, you're wrong.
Okay, keep it coming. This is a
more
blizzard,
snow.
Gentlemen.
Yes, more snow.
What are you doing, slumming?
Oh, Herb, of course. What else? Come here, I want you to meet Jack Dempsey. Herb Brennan. Not much of a film director, but one swell fella.
A pleasure, Mr. Dempsey.
Jack.
Jack who?
Dempsey. Jack Dempsey.
Taylor. Estelle Taylor.
Come on, Dempsey, you're supposed to be in training.
I want to see you again.
I'm a married lady.
No wedding ring.
It's in a bank vault. Along with my husband, I haven't seen him in 3 years.
I want to see you again.
What for?
There's no answer to that. Dinner. That's a good what for. How about dinner? Will you hold your horses, Woody? What do you say?
Why should I have dinner with you?
Because you have no reason not to.
You do away with words, don't you?
Only a few. Tonight, 7 o'clock.
7:30. And no promises.
I'm not asking for any. Wear something simple.
Not a chance. Hey, Ginsburg.
Ginsburg?
Well, you don't expect me to call you champ, do you? Don't be late, Ginsburg.
Not a chance.
Ready, Mr. Dempsey.
So am I.
Come on, Ginsburg. Your public awaits you.
Let him wait.
Dempsey in there?
Yeah, but he's a little tied up right now.
This what you call working out on the speed bag?
Doc. When did you get back in town?
Just now.
Good to see you. Honey, I want you to meet Doc Kearns, my manager and my best friend. Doc, say hello to Estelle Taylor.
How do you do, Mr. Kearns? Jack has told me all about you.
Then you have the advantage. Nobody has told me all about you.
Mr. Dempsey.
Yeah, I'll be right with you, Eddie.
Why don't you two get acquainted? I won't be long. Doc, why don't you tell Estelle all about New York? Honey, this man owns New York City.
You want to know about New York?
Not really.
I want you to marry me. Didn't you hear me? I asked you to marry me.
No, you didn't. You said, I want you to marry me. That's not the same thing. Call that a proposal.
Miss Taylor, will you please marry me?
That's better.
Well, will you?
Give me one good reason why I should.
Because I love you.
That's a good reason. We'll have to wait.
Why? Wait for what?
Till I get a divorce.
Well, how long is that going to take?
Not long. Can't you wait?
No.
Good morning, Mr. Dempsey. You know, just because we own this hotel doesn't mean you can come waltzing in all hours of the night. Where you been?
I can early call, Doc. Talk about it.
Talk about it now.
What's your beef, Doc? If something's eating you, why don't you just spill it?
This dame's got you by the throat, kid. Look at yourself. Dark shadows under your eyes, soft gut. You're spending money on her like she's the Queen of Sheba. I've checked. And I'm not through yet. You're all out of shape. You couldn't go three rounds with my grandmother.
First off, if you'd have gotten me a fight in the last 2 years, maybe I'd have had a reason to be in shape. Second off, Estelle is none of your business.
What makes her so different?
Well, that's something you wouldn't understand.
Try me.
All right. No, you really wouldn't understand. By the way, me and Estelle are going to Europe. On our honeymoon. Hey, here he comes.
He's drunk.
Where's the booze?
Sit down, Doc.
Yes, sir, Mr. Champion. Well, 3 months in Europe, you're looking trim, champ.
So this is the lucky lady, huh? Do I call you Mrs. Dempsey or do I call him Mr. Taylor? Did she ever tell you about this Walsh character she was shagging up with?
Watch your mouth, Doc.
Watch your mouth, Doc. You don't mind if I have a snort?
You're pathetic.
Takes one to know one.
I said watch your mouth, Doc.
This Walsh guy was a married man. Did she tell you that? His wife was very upset with your lady friend here. It was a real juicy scandal with Miss Hollywood movie star here as the main attraction.
I don't have to listen to this.
Is the truth too much for you?
Truth? Well, the truth is you're nothing but a parasite.
And you're a no-talent actress trying to use my boy to open the doors for you.
No-talent actress? You wouldn't know talent if it spit in your face.
I know you, lady. You're nothing but a diamond to...
Coming, Jack? I don't particularly feel like dining out this evening.
Attaboy, champ. Run home to mama.
yourself.
I don't want that man in my home. I don't want that man in my life or yours. I don't need him, and neither do you.
Estelle Back was drunk.
Jack, it's either him or me.
Now, you don't mean that.
Like hell I don't.
What's in your mind, kid?
It's all over, Doc.
You and the dame.
You and me. We're through.
Through with what?
Everything.
It ain't that easy, kid. I own 50% of you.
And you took 50% of me. You never owned it.
So the lady finally cut my throat, huh?
No, you cut your own throat, Doc. I'm not a kid anymore. I haven't been for a long time. I'm running my own life now.
Tell that to your wife, not me.
I'm very grateful to you, Doc. I always will be. I just think it's time we both went our own separate ways.
Just like that.
No. Nothing's just like that.
I made you rich, kid, remember?
I made you rich, too.
I earned it.
So did I. I was the one taking the punches, not you. It was my blood in the ring, not yours. That's something you'll never understand. So long, Doc.
See you in court, champ. You didn't really think you'd win this without a fight, did you?
Don't worry about Kearns, Jack.
It's actually 6 months he's been on my back. He's suing me left and right. He's even got a lien on all my cash. It's frozen in the bank.
Kearns is only blowing smoke rings. Doesn't stand a chance in court. Tell me, you and Gene Normeal getting along okay?
Fine. He's a good man. Good man.
Well, he's no Doc Kearns, but he's honest. Thank you.
Thank you.
Prohibition. If it wasn't so pathetic, it'd be funny.
No, thanks.
As I was saying, Normeal. He's a good manager for you. He'll protect your money.
Tex, I need a fight more than I need the money. I never thought I'd hear myself say that, but that's the way I feel.
You had a great time. Hey, champ!
How are you?
Good to see you.
Yeah. How you been?
Oh, I can't complain. Still hitting the ball a mile.
So I hear.
The rest don't matter, huh? What are you doing in town? I hope it's a fight. You know, you're the only sure bet I know around here. Hey, Tex.
You're looking great, kid.
Feeling good, babe. Sit down. Join us for a drink.
Oh, have a drink.
Well, maybe later. I got to get a few of my pals loaded first, huh? Good to see you.
Good to see you, babe.
Tex?
Hey, get off of my stool. What are you guys doing?
Everybody likes the babe.
Yeah, well, everybody acts like they do. It's not the same thing, Jack.
No, I suppose not. Tex, I haven't had a fight now for over 3 years. Now, I've been living a pretty good life in Hollywood, and I've been making these silly little movies, but I'm a fighter. Now, I know there's a time a man should quit, but that time hasn't come for me yet. Now, there's got to be somebody who can fight me for the title.
Well, there's that new kid, Tunney.
Marine.
Yeah. You know, he dropped Gibbons in 12. It took you 15 rounds to put Gibbons away.
Tex, Tommy Gibbons was 3 years younger when I fought him. Get me Tunney. You set the deal, and I'll fight him anytime, anywhere. Just get me Tunney.
All right, Jack. Leave it to me. Now, tell me, what is all this stuff I read about your being in a Broadway play?
Well, it's on the square. Estelle wants to do it. I'm just sort of along for the ride.
A Broadway play directed by David Belasco? That's going to be some ride.
It's going to be a disaster.
They worked up Mr. Dempsey's first entrance. He looked exceedingly trim and well-pressed and somehow cute. Cute, almost like a Cupid blowing up to 10 times natural size. I'm sorry, Estelle. You gotta admit it's funny.
How's this for a laugh? Miss Taylor of the movies must have given them a harder time to get ready. She's unfortunate enough to know how to act badly. Well, why don't you laugh?
Old brother.
How much does Jack stand to lose on this epic?
$80,000. That's a lot of cash to keep a marriage together.
Dempsey needs is another fight. What about it, huh? You're his manager, Gene. Is Dempsey going to fight Tunney?
This September, in Philadelphia.
I'm sorry.
Well, what are you sorry for, honey? Hmm? We didn't stand a chance. It was a fix all the way.
Head away. Head away. Now use that jet. Back up, Jack! Back up! It's too soon for that! Sticking with it.
What's this, World War II?
No, just a precaution. A lot of crackpots around.
Good morning, Mrs. O'Neill.
Good morning.
Who's that?
That's Mike Trent, Jack's bodyguard.
Bodyguard? Come on, Gene, what's going on here?
It's Doc Kearns, Estelle. He's pulling every legal string in the book to try to stop the fight. He's got process service coming at us from all four sides. Last night, it cost us a $100,000 bond just to keep Jack out of jail. And he was sleeping. So, don't tell him about it, okay? He's got enough on his mind without Kearns bothering.
Still, I can see that you're worried about me. And that makes me worry.
Jack, it's been 3 years. Now, 3 years of not doing something doesn't mean you can still do it. Not like you used to. Quit this madness. You've still got your whole life ahead of you.
Quit and do what?
There are 100 things you can do.
Name one.
Business. You're the champ. People like you. They'll buy anything from you. You can make a fortune in real estate. Movies. You could produce movies.
You really don't understand me, do you? I am in business. My business is fighting. I love to fight.
You can't fight all your life.
Go back to New York. I'll see you after the fight.
Here you go, Jack.
Oh, no,
not
today,
Mike. No. Today's the day can do you the most good. Besides, the fight's not till tomorrow night anyway. So, cheers.
Yeah. Olive oil, I hate this stuff.
That's for sure. I'll get your bag for you.
Let's go, Trent.
No, I still got a lockup. Oh, Jerry, leave me a car and I'll catch up to you at the station.
Train leaves at noon.
We'll be there.
Mr. Armillo.
You'll have to call up the fight.
If that's a joke, Jerry. I'm not laughing.
No jokes. See for yourself.
Jack, what is it? What's the matter?
I don't know. My stomach is...
Let's get him to the car. Where's Trent?
He never showed. That's why we're a day late. We waited for him as long as we could.
Let's go.
Here, Jack, chew some more ice. It'll help settle your stomach.
If I puke one more time, I think I'm gonna pass out.
Raining. Just a drizzle. We got about 15 minutes. Any better?
Yeah, a little bit.
How are the legs?
Like rubber.
Jack, you want me to call it off?
No, I'm gonna be okay.
You sure?
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. Take the left of the head. And another left! Now they're moving back. They go into a clinch. Sonny looks too strong for the champ. And there is the bell ending round 4. No question about it, ladies and gentlemen. Boxing history is being made here tonight. Jack Dempsey, the heavyweight champion of the world, is taking a beating. Gene Tunney, the challenger, the ex-Marine, looks invincible. The champ is slow. His punches seem to have lost the sting that
Harry's done for.
Shut up, Harry.
Bill trying to land the one punch that will save his title. But Sonny won't let Dempsey near him. Dempsey is still on his feet. 10 rounds of punishment. The champ is still standing. But it's over, ladies and gentlemen. It's over. And there's the bell. Heavyweight champion of the world, Gene Tunney!
Yeah.
operator. Give me the desk. This is Mrs. Jack Dempsey, Suite 724. I'd like a ticket on the first available train to Philadelphia.
Brent was behind this. I checked on him. He made two phone calls to the Sherman Hotel where some very unsavory characters I know were staying.
Which doesn't prove a thing.
Oh, I'm not finished. Jack is a 3-to-1 favorite to beat Tunney, right?
Yeah.
Yesterday, in Chicago, Frankie Pope lays $500,000 clams on Tunney to win. Now, nobody's going to tell me that Frankie Pope is going to bet that kind of money on anything, unless he knows there's no way he can lose.
Gene, I took olive oil every day I was in training.
Yes. And you didn't get sick once, right? You want more proof than that? I'm telling you, somebody paid Trent to doctor that last drink.
Well, I'd be careful about jumping to conclusions.
It's, worth looking into.
This is all bleeding heart stuff. I don't need an alibi.
Jack, you were robbed.
I wasn't robbed, Gene. I got beat. And I got beat by a better man. You understand? No, I don't want to hear any more about it. That's it.
That's what?
Still, I'm glad you're here.
Gentlemen, that's our exit line.
What happened, Ginsburg?
Well, I forgot to duck. You should have been there still. I never heard him cheer like that before.
Let's go home, Jack.
That's good. That's good. Now left, right, hook. That's it. Good. All right, side to side. Now keep your hands up. Good, good, good. Now hook. Hook. Hook.
Thought it was a hook to the body and then a hook to the head.
These wise guys keep dropping by and telling me how to box.
So how's the place doing?
Oh, that's great. Even making a few bucks now. Be able to pay you back soon.
Well, you don't owe me a thing.
Talk to Mom?
Oh, not for about a week. She still can't get over my not being champion anymore.
Well, you'd think she lost the title.
Well, in a way, she did.
Well, we gave them a run for their money, didn't we, champ? Listen, I always wanted to thank you for keeping your word about letting me work the corner when you were the champ. I never dreamed it would be so big. Excitement, the crowds. Boy, I really miss it. Well, listen to me going on here, what I know. I mean, I was just there. You lived it. You really lived it. Nobody can ever take that away from you. How do you stand it, Harry? If I were you, I think I'd be going crazy right now.
See you around, Bray.
Hey, champ. Keeping busy?
Oh, yeah. I'm in business now. Real estate broker. Even got my own license.
has been.
Hey, babe. You big tub of lard.
Good to see you.
Yeah. Kid, you look like something the cat dragged in.
Yeah, well, this is my successful businessman look.
Yeah. You got a minute?
All the time in the world for you.
You know, I was going to come up to your house this week.
Thought you'd be down in Florida.
Didn't you read the papers? I'm still holding out for more dough. I'll be back, huh? I miss you, champ. I miss watching you fight. You know, the day you step out of the ring for good, I don't care how many guys step in after you. You'll still be in a class by yourself.
Oh, thanks, babe. That means a lot coming from you.
So why don't you do an old pal a favor, huh? Take plenty apart.
I tried it.
So what? I don't always hit a home run, you know.
No, I'm through, babe. That's one thing I do know.
You don't know nothing. You know, you owe it to yourself and to your fans to give it one more shot.
What fans?
What fans? Every place I go, people are stopping me saying, where's the champ? What's he doing? When's he gonna fight Tunney? Pals of mine tell me that letters are pouring into sports writers all over the country asking about you. Here you are, walking sideways and bumping into yourself.
It's not that simple, babe.
If it was simple, what'd be the point in doing anything? Jackie, just like me. Guys like us, we can't just back off from the spotlight. We gotta keep going up the bat until we grind ourselves into the ground.
It's not the same. You got a whole team behind you. I lost that championship alone.
It is the same. You think that every time I go up to bat, I'm not alone? I'm at zero.
I don't know if I still got what it takes.
One way to find out. Let me ask you something. Didn't that title mean anything to you?
It meant everything to me.
Then get it back.
You're gonna fight Tunney again, aren't you?
I don't know. I haven't broken a sweat in 9 months. I don't know if I can even fight again. All I know is I gotta find out.
What about me?
It has nothing to do with you.
Well, you're right about one thing. I don't understand you. I never will.
This is something I've got to do, Estelle.
With me or without me?
Either way, I gotta try.
Go on, try. Only this time I won't be there to pick up the pieces.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, from Soldiers Field, Chicago. Tonight, September 22nd, 1927, we may all be part of boxing history. For no fighter has ever regained the heavyweight title once he lost it. There are those who tried, James J. Corbett, John L. Sullivan, to name two. Tonight, with over 100,000 boxing fanatics watching and countless millions listening, one of the greatest champions of all time, William Harrison Jack Dempsey, will attempt to regain the heavyweight title he lost to Gene Tunney, the current champion. There's the warning bell. Let's join ring announcer Joe Humphreys for the introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. This is the main event of the evening, 10 rounds of boxing, and a rematch for the heavyweight championship of the world. In this corner, wearing black trunks, weighing in at an even 192 pounds, from Manassas, Colorado, the former heavyweight champion of the world, tonight the challenger, the Manassas Mauler, Jack Dempsey. Wearing white trunks, weighing in at 189 and a half pounds, from New York City, New York, known as the fighting U.S. Marine, the heavyweight champion of the world, Gene Tunney.
Dempsey, Tunney, you both know the rules. In the event of a knockdown, the man scoring the knockdown must go to a neutral corner in order for me to stop my count.
You know, if Dempsey would have stuck with me, he never would have had to lose his title in the first place.
Or maybe he'll win it back tonight.
Not without me to tell him what to do.
Doesn't look good.
Jack, you gotta stay away from that guy.
Now how the hell am I gonna hit him?
Now, don't get careless. Watch that left hook of his. He's not finished yet. And keep that left hand moving. Move, jab. You understand?
You're still way behind on points. You have to knock him out.
Except for a couple of minor flare-ups, it has been all Tunney so far. Dempsey is making a better showing than he did the night he lost the title to Gene Tunney. But it isn't nearly enough. The young champion is too strong, too fast. There's the bell for round 7.
Mm-hmm.
My pleasure, and indeed my personal honor, to present to you tonight the greatest fighter of the past 50 years, Jack Dempsey.
No applause than I got when I beat Willard for the title.
Coming here tonight, I had only one regret. That I couldn't share this honor with two of my dearest friends, Tex Rickard and Damon Runyon. But as I look around this room, I can feel them here, and I'm glad. There's another friend here tonight who rightfully shares this honor with me. Talking about Jack Kearns. Kearns told me I was the greatest fighter in the world. And I believed him. Ladies and gentlemen, Jack Kearns made me a champion. I was one of the lucky ones. Fighting has been more than just good to me. Not because it made me a lot of money. Not because it made me a somebody. Not because it taught me how to be a man. But because fighting gave me a life. That I never would have dreamed possible. Fighting gave me the chance to meet some of the finest people on this earth. And I'll always be grateful for that.